particular, the debate between you and Congressman Aiken, you had a lot of agreement, except at the end with both his time in Washington and the earmark distinction. What did you think of his answer, particularly on both of those things?
Well, I don't agree with him on earmarks at all. I don't think we should have earmarks. And what his argument about how Congress is abdicating their responsibility of appropriating money, that's not true whatsoever. You know, you can appropriate money just like we do in here in Missouri, in the public, in committees where people have an opportunity to comment on what's being spent, if the project has merit, if it doesn't have merit. It doesn't turn over spending to the executive branch. It just means that Congress has to do a little more work, and they have to do it in public where it's transparent and people can see what they're doing.
We'll see. There was a lot of agreement between you and Treasurer Steelman. The one distinction and one back and forth was both over the earmark situation and over Medicare vote. Do you have anything else to respond of what she said about either of those issues?
No, I pretty much like to keep what I'm saying on who I am, why I voted the way I did. If people distort my record or reasoning, then I feel like I'll respond to that. But, I feel like the people listen to a debate to see who is the person and not who are you going to run down. So I didn't talk about things where Sarah and I differ and things that she did that I don't agree with.
You mentioned there was some distinction between, and I'm paraphrasing here, I know this was the exact word, like egregious earmarks and ones that are more proper. What specifically would you say is a proper earmark?
Well, the thing is the big problem you're dealing with is there is no clear definition of earmark, okay? And I think that it's wrong to designate that some company is going to get government money. Okay, but I don't think it's wrong to say that, for instance, the Department of Defense needs to invest in putting a Hellfire missile on a drone. Okay, we're not talking about sending money to some company or helping out or cronyism. We're simply talking about how the federal government should spend money. We must maintain that First Amendment capability, or we're not going to be a Congress anymore.
But would you, for example, send that money for that drone to any company besides Boeing, which is in Missouri?
Sure, absolutely. Now, there's some places, for instance, like I worked hard on adapting the F-18 to replace another plane that was falling apart. It was a bucket of bolts. Mm-hmm. And the only people making a plane that flies off an aircraft carrier was Boeing. But even then, that airplane is assembled and built in all kinds of states all over them. So I don't call that an earmark, but I think Congress has to maintain their capability of funding things and say to the President, no, we're not going to fund that, that's a waste, and yes, we will fund this. And if we lose that distinctiveness just for political gotcha, then we're not really being honest and doing our job.